En cualquier caso, tú eras un espía, no trabajabas en una ONG, es un trabajo un poco diferente. Quiero decir, durante todo el tiempo que estuviste hasta que diste el paso y decidiste que había algo que no te gustaba, ¿nunca viste cosas raras, nunca había nada que te incomodara? ¿Por qué un día dijiste, voy a hacer esto?
But no one in that building, no one in these agencies signed up to watch everyone in the United States, which is what we had ended up doing without there ever being a vote, without the public ever knowing at all. And this is important because even had the public said, yes, this is okay, I'm all right with it, it was forbidden in the Constitution.
Cualquier persona, cualquier ciudadano, cualquier político, ¿a qué tipo de gente se estaba espiando?
We were spying on lawyers who were negotiating trade deals over the price of shrimp and clove cigarettes. We were spying on the United Nations Children Fund. We were spying on journalists. We were spying on professors in the United States who were actually, they held security clearances themselves. These weren't people who were known to be associated with violence. These weren't people who were suspected of being terrorists. These were people who instead had what would be considered some intelligence value. And this is critical, because these programs were never about terrorism. That was the justification. They're about diplomatic manipulation, economic espionage, and social control. They're about power. And there's no question that mass surveillance increases the powers of government, right? But the idea here is, if we've had 3 years of reporting that say, for example, the NSA is collecting the communications of Angela Merkel, of Berlusconi, of Sarkozy and Hollande, and these are our allies who we trust the most, who are the richest, sort of most powerful countries out there. Is it really so hard to believe that they would be monitoring ordinary people who have no special political influence to deter aggressive actions against them? Do you think the NSA would have more respect for your rights than they would for someone who could actually protest against them in a meaningful way?